We're here today because we've both done this job a long time and we've seen far too many road deaths on the roads of West Yorkshire.
So we just want to deliver some messages to try and make people think about when they're out on the road and what their responsibilities are as a driver or indeed as a passenger.
And what sort of messages would you like to get across to people?
Collisions can happen for a variety of reasons. We've also got the fatal four, which are your speed, mobile phones, seatbelt and drink driving. But also collisions can happen for a number of other reasons. So for example, we MOT our cars and get them serviced, but how often do we look at ourselves and MOT and check ourselves?
Yeah, so we don't really want it to be like a you won't do this or you won't do that kind of message. We want it to be more like a gentle nudge for people just to think about their own responsibility as a driver, but not just themselves, like the loved ones, the mums, the dads, just to be a little bit more mindful about, am I fit to drive, but also are people close to me, are they fit to drive as well?
So it might well be that you've got a relative who says they don't like driving at night anymore, but why is that? Is it because they haven't had their eyesight tested? When did you last have your eyesight tested? Are you okay to be out on the road and driving?
Or for example, shift workers or people that may have been studying that are having late nights, are you tired? Are you in a fit state to drive? Perhaps on medication for anything, it could be hay fever medication, is it making you drowsy or cold flu medication, things like that?
Yeah, indeed, medication isn't just about what you get prescribed by your doctor, it can be something that you've bought over the counter. So check that medication, does it say it can affect your driving? For the sake of 2 seconds, have a quick look and check that packaging.
And has there been a number of road deaths this year, for example?
Yes, yeah, so far this year, we've had in excess of 40 deaths on the roads this year of West Yorkshire. Any death is one too many, so that's why we're here today. We just really want to try and get that message across to people to check themselves and their loved ones.
And it's not just perhaps people behind the wheel who might be involved in a fatal collision?
Fatal collisions affect so many people, not just the driver of a vehicle involved, but it can affect indeed their passengers, and that's not to take away from how it can affect the victims of a road death, or even people that are just seriously injured. It has a massive impact on families. So even as a passenger in a vehicle, you might have a responsibility to say to the driver if you don't feel comfortable with their driving, or check them. Don't be afraid to do that, it's everybody's responsibility.
So does having a driving licence mean you're automatically fit to drive?
No, it doesn't. Don't get complacent with journeys. It might be a journey that you've driven every day, you might drive it twice a day, but that doesn't mean that you should take your concentration off the road. You know, we've seen collisions where it's someone's familiar area where they live, but that split second of lapse of concentration because you've come blasé about it can have tragic consequences.
So just remember that having a driving licence isn't necessarily a right, it's a privilege, and it's a privilege that you've gained by going through your driving lessons and then passing that driving test, and it doesn't take a lot for you to lose that licence. So I'd ask yourself, is it worth it?